Coming up, we're in California's Pebble Beach to show you the brand new Bentley Mulsanne, unveil an all-new American supercar called Devon, and tell you why it's been a good week for the owner of this 1937 classic. The Pebble Beach Concours d'Elegance is kind of like the ultimate beauty pageant, but for cars. It just happens to be set in some of the most picturesque environment I've ever seen. We're actually on a golf course overlooking the Pacific. Surprisingly, the car getting all the attention at this year's Pebble Beach isn't actually a classic. It's the all-new Bentley Mulsanne. It really is all new. And this is the first car that was fully conceived, designed and engineered at Crewe. And the other thing is, it's going to be built in Crewe in an all-new facility. I mean, it's very traditional Bentley as well. I mean, there's a massive grille up front, has loads of presents, lovely bit of jewellery in the front lights, and underneath this hood is going to be an all-new 6¾-litre V8 engine. They're getting pretty tight-lipped about pricing, but you can expect to pay around £200,000 when it hits showrooms in the middle of 2010.
It wasn't just the new Bentley causing a stir at Pebble Beach this week. Oh no, there was also this new Devon GTX supercar. The Devon, which we'd like to think was named after the hoss bossy Knight Rider rather than the sleepy British county, is loosely based on the Dodge Viper, but don't let that put you off. The 8.4-litre V10 engine's been tweaked right up to 650 horsepower, which no doubt helped when it broke the Laguna Seca lap record last weekend. Just listen to the thing. It's all bespoke engineered underneath too. The bodywork's also made entirely from carbon fibre, which you might expect considering it costs $500,000. Still, it looks pretty awesome.
Porsche has revealed the GT3 RS, the homologation special built to the 911 Go Racing. Power from the 3.8-litre engine is up to 444 bhp. It's wider to accommodate ludicrously large tyres, there's a built-in roll cage, and you get a monster rear wing. It hits Blighty next January and can be yours for $100,000. Shame about the chavvy graphics though.
Spanish carmaker Seat has just announced its most powerful car ever. The 261 brake horsepower León Cupra R is said to debut at September's Frankfurt Motor Show and will hit 60 miles an hour in 6.1 seconds. That's just 0.2 seconds off the pace of a Ford Focus RS. Nice work, guys, but can't you crank up the styling a little bit?
This week, Volvo celebrates 50 years of the seatbelt with this surprisingly interesting video.
Niels Bullin realised at an early stage that both the upper and lower areas of the body must be securely restrained with a belt over the chest area and another over the thighs. The greatest challenge was to create a solution that was both simple and effective, as it had to be possible to access and fasten the seatbelt with one hand.
Former race ace Johnny Herbert has decided to do a bit of a Nigel Mansell by swapping his Formula One threads for a drive in the British Touring Cars Championship. Johnny's going to be racing in the season's final three rounds for Team Dynamics Honda, and we've got a fiver on him busting out a Mansell-inspired Supertash 2.
It's official, people. The only electronic device you need in your life is an iPhone. It's taken a while, but with the introduction of the new Fastly 3GS model, proper turn-by-turn satellite navigation apps are now available, and TomTom is the first company to unlock the potential. The app costs £60 to download, which seems pretty reasonable value to us, and from what we heard, it works really well. That is until you get to a really tricky junction and someone phones you. Don't.
It was a good week for Robert Lee of Nevada as his stunning 1937 classic was crowned best of show at the super prestigious Pebble Beach Concours d'Elegance. We didn't have a clue what it was either, but apparently it's a Horch 853 Vol and Rubik Sport Cabriolet, and that award should make it even more priceless.
It was another bad week for ex-Toro Rosso driver Sebastian Bourdais when it leaked out that he'd been fired from his drive by text message. Harsh.
Don't miss our rundown of this season's hottest convertibles. Wig wearers need not apply.